My fault, I was trying to get my drawers out my ass. Oh, I'm just glad to be back in a real city with some real brothers, man. Damn, because last week I was doing a show in Louisiana. I grew up in Ohio. They was acting like I had an accent. Every time I said something, they was on me like, "What are you saying, black man? We can't understand you. What do you want from us?" I was like, "Excuse me for using a subject and a verb on your monkey ass." That's what I said. Damn, man, because they just country. It's brothers down south don't even know slavery is over yet. I swear. I was walking through the airport in Alabama. This brother ran up to me like, "I was going for my freedom tonight, man. Is you coming or is you ain't? We ain't gonna never have to worry about nothing no more." I was like, "Nah, money, I'm gonna stay here with the white folks, all right? I'm a house nigga, all right?" Damn, man, whew. Oh my God, but I gotta give a shout out too, man. We had a black pilot flying out here. I was proud as hell, flat out. But you know, you don't see too many brothers flying planes, man. I was happy, serious. Check it. I had to take a double take. You know, I was expecting to see a white dude. I walked in, I was like, I. Hey. I walked up in the cockpit, I was like, "Yo, money, fly this motherfucker. Shit, I got your back." We sat down, he scared the hell out of me, man. Brother came on the microphone, "Yo, this your pilot, Scooty B, I'm in the house. Yo, we gonna be leaving Ohio on a route. We gonna go through, that next state. We just gonna end up in New York, all right?" I'm nervous as hell, right? Then to make matters worse, we backing up from the gate. This brother hit something, man. Then he gonna stick his head out the window talking about, "Y'all saw me backing up, didn't you? Is this a plane? Get your ass out the way then." Damn, they know I'm on probation. Damn. You know? Because I'm used to them white pilots, man. They tell you all kind of dumb shit, don't they? I'm on there trying to sleep. He come on, "This is your captain, Bob." I'm up here in the cockpit. I'm like, "That's a good place for your ass, Bob." You know, tell me some shit I don't know. He come on talking about, "This Bob, I'm down here in the luggage rack." Now that's some shit I need to know, all right? Damn, serious. Boy. Then you get them other white pilots. They want to be tour guides and shit. "This motherfucker, if you look to the left of the plane, you'll see the Grand Canyon." I'm like, "Keep your damn eyes on the sky, all right? If I wanted to see shit on the ground, I'd have drove." Damn. Bull. I ain't gonna lie. And then, man, I ain't gonna lie, y'all, we had a flight attendant that stuttered. I almost pissed on myself laughing. By the time she finished the safety briefing, we was landing, man. She was up in the aisleway, in case of a loss of cabin. Everybody on the plane was like, we was sweating and shit, man. Finally, I couldn't stand it. I got up and said, "Damn, bitch, get hooked on phonics, all right? Damn. Boy, I couldn't take it. Pissing me off, man. Because y'all remember when flight attendants used to be all sexy and shit, had booties, pam. Now they hiring any hoe that ain't scared of heights, man. I ain't lying. We had a flight attendant, man, her booty was so big, she was coming down the aisle knocking drinks out of people's hands and shit. She bent over to pick up a napkin, some dude's arm went clean up her ass, man. He had a little drink bottle on his hand, lost that motherfucker. That's 450 up the ass, you know. I'm like, "Yo, money, if I was you, I'd go get that. Yo, wipe off the top, you can drink.